If you can, please stand up.
私は心を尽くして主に感謝しよう。素直な人の集いと集会において主の御業は偉大で、御業を喜ぶすべての人々に尋ね求められる。その御業は千言と栄光、その義は永遠に固く立つ。主はその美しい技を記念とされた。主は情け深く笑い深く、主を恐れる者を痛む者を、その契約を常に覚えておられる。日本の民の譲り命をご自分の民に与え、彼らにその技の力を続け示せられた。見ての技は真実と聖書の全て、今しやしめは確かである。それらはいよいよ限りなく保たれ、誠と正しさをもって行われる。主は御民にあがないを送り、ご自分の契約を教え定められた。主の御業は聖であり、恐れ多い。恐れることは知恵の始め、これを行う人はみんな良い目誘える。主のおまねは励ましてくれるから、だから前向いて後ろ振り返らずに進もう。いつもいつもあなたがいる、希望が心にある。だから前向いて進み続けてゆくんだ。いつだって勇気出して行ける行けるように、あなたがそばにいる。こんな深い愛は初めてだから、あなたが共にいるっていうこと、生きる希望になる。だから笑顔で進み続けよう、あなたも一緒に。いつもいつもあなたがいる、励ましてくれるから、だから前向いて後ろ振り返らずに進もう。いつもいつもあなたがいる、希望が心にある。だから前向いて進み続けてゆくんだ。いつだって涙拭いて生きていけるように、あなたと共に行く永遠。 たも一緒に Hold your head high Keep your head high Look up to heaven You have a bright future Hold your head high Keep your head highLook up to heaven You have a bright future あなたが語られたなら主の約束があるなら受けたと信じよう。その通りになるから私は癒されました。私は許されました。私は祝福受けました。皆をたたえます。あなたが語られたなら主の約束があるなら受けたと信じよう。その通りになるから全ての問題困難あなたは勝利取られた。言葉の通りになりました。皆をあがめます。私は癒されます。私は癒されました。私は許されました。私は祝福受けました。皆をたたえます。与えられた恵みを思う。天の都に住まう日々を思え歌う。苦しみの表される主の栄光。この喜びを賛美に乗せてイエスに歌う。どんな荒野も泉が湧く。主の輪があるならば全世界に今出て行き良き知らせ伝えよう。与えられた証を持って語り続けよう。全世界に今出て行き良き知らせ伝え
give up and don't become weary. Stand in my, on my word and be courageous. By my word is true, and my word will come to pass. I have given you many promises. Those promises are true. If you trust in them and obey me, you see the essence and the coming true of those promises. You have already seen some fruit, but you'll be seeing more greater fruit. Use your faith. The reward that you will receive will be great. Don't be afraid of difficulties, because there is no difficulty that cannot be overwhelmed through me. I will give you strength, and I will do my work, and I will show my glory, and my glory will be made manifest in all over the world, said the Lord. Please be seated. We now have the Holy Communion. The Holy Communion is to proclaim the death of Jesus in our church. You are welcome to join the ceremony if you believe in the Lord Jesus as your Savior and you have been baptized or you'd like to be baptized in the near future. Even if you are not a member of this church, if you are watching this service on the internet, please join this ceremony if you believe in the Lord Jesus as your Savior and you have been baptized, or you'd like to be baptized in the near future. Let me pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I pray for you to bless this bread and wine and grape juice here. And please bless bread and wine and grape juice that those who are watching this service on the internet have prepared. Now let us have a time of repentance in prayer, silently. And if you have sins in your hearts, please confess them to God. We pray these prayers in the name of Jesus. Amen. Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take it, this is my body. Let's partake in the body of Christ.Jesus said to them, This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Let's partake in the body of Christ. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for the grace of this Holy Communion. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. We now have a time of offerings.
神の国と神の義をまず求めなさい。そうすれば与えられる。ハレル、ハレルヤ。Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things shall be added unto you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. それでは宮下牧師をお祈りください。
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you that you know our needs and you feel them. We now have offered our offerings. I pray that you will sanctify them and use them for your work. I also pray that you will bless those who have offered.Both spiritually and practically. Amen. With thanksgiving in the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Please open your Bible to Psalm 103, verse from 8. Psalm 103, verse from 10 to 11. He does not treat us as our sins deserve, or repay us according to our iniquities. For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for those who fear him. Let me pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for gathering us together here. We are going to learn from your word. You, the living God, please speak to us abundantly. Thank you for your special grace and blessing. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Good evening, everyone. To those who are watching this service on the internet, good evening, good morning, and hello. We have been back to Japan from Hawaii. Let's watch a short movie about this outreach to Hawaii.
To ございます。
Thank you. From last Monday to last Thursday, we went to Hawaii during this outreach in Hawaii. I experienced a difficulty the day before departure. Some of you might have recognized that, but I had a very bad condition. On Sunday, I felt dizzy, and it was like I suffered from anemia. And if I tried to keep standing up, I would collapse. So, and that would surprise you a lot. So I used to sit on a chair during the services. And I thought that in this condition, I would not be able to go to Hawaii. If I would go, I would collapse. But I had experienced the same kind of thing. That was when I was going to join an outreach to a certain country. And that was also the day before my departure. I had high fever, and I thought I wouldn't be able to go on the outreach. But when I prayed to God, God said, go. So I did go. And while I was on, during my flight to that country, I was completely healed. So last Sunday, I also thought that it was spiritual attack against my body to keep me from going on this outreach to Hawaii. And now, looking back to the first experience, I now think that if I had not joined that team because of the high fever, so many works of overseas missions will not have been opened up for our church. Last Sunday, Pastor Majikina asked me if I would need him to give me a ride to Narita Airport the next day. But I answered him no thank you, because if this was a real physical disease, I would collapse before leaving Japan, and I would be hospitalized. And I prayed to God, and God said, go to Hawaii. And as I left Japan for Hawaii, I was totally healed, and I was in a very good condition during my stay in Hawaii. I believe that was severe spiritual attack to keep me from joining this outreach. And afterward, I heard that Pastor Taniguchi of Fuji Philadelphia Church, she also suffered from the same kind of thing, dizziness and like anemia, before the day of, before this Hawaii team. And Mr. Koichi, living in Hawaii, who helped me with this outreach, he also suffered from the same bad condition like me. Through hearing those things, I have been able to confirm that that was a spiritual attack. And because of this, and And God had a special purpose and significant purpose for this outreach. In Hawaii, we saw many rainbows. About rainbows, you think much of a rainbow because the Bible said that rainbow is a sign of promise. No, the Bible said that rainbow is a sign of contract. But it's not actually a sign of contract. Contract is made between, for example, Pastor Kobayashi and me. Both of them agree to one thing. That's a contract. But when we read a passage, the passage about Noah in the Bible, the Lord showed a rainbow, promising them that he would never destroy the earth by flood again. So that was a promise. So a rainbow is a sign of promise, confirming us that his promises would come to pass. The time I started seeing a rainbow, it was a very impressive experience. At that time, I had never seen any rainbow for the past 20 years. And that was about the time when I started to pioneer this church. And one day, I thought in my heart, in my mind, that rainbow had not appeared, and I hadn't seen a rainbow for a long time. Then the Lord spoke to me. The Lord spoke to me that I will show you a rainbow as a sign of blessing, just as is written in the book by Pastor Jack Hereford. And after a little time later, we went to the United States. And when we prayed at the prayer chapel of church on the way, God again spoke to us that he would show us a rainbow whenever he confirms his promises for us. And coming back to Japan, during our flight going back to Japan, we saw a rainbow. I have another testimony about the rainbow. It was when we had a church in Kokubunji city, and I used to give a message in the international service in those days. Even now, I give a message in the international service once a month. But at that time, a man came to attend the international service, and he counseled with me. I counseled with him, and he told me that he was now in the court. His wife and he were fighting in the court, and his wife tried to divorce him, and he didn't want to be divorced, so he was in a very difficult situation. And his attorney told him that he would probably lose the suit. So his attorney suggested to him that he should make a reconciliation with his wife, so that he would not have to pay so much money, because if he lost the suit, he would have to pay to her a lot. And so I counseled with him, and he insisted. But there was a prophecy through me saying that he should not give up. He should continue to fight in the court because God would let him win, and they would not have to. He would not have to be divorced. And then a very strange thing happened. He didn't lose the suit in the suit, because the judge resigned in the middle of the suit. But probably there was a lot of fault on his side. His wife continued the suit court again, and she hired another judge, and the suit court continued. And this man came over to our church once again, and I counseled with him, and he said the same thing. He was persuaded by his attorney to be reconciled with her, and let her divorce him. But again, I told him, don't give up, because God will let you win. And what do you know what happened? The new judge again, he resigned. So they couldn't conclude the suit court. And the next time I met him was when we had a charismatic meeting in Shibuya, and he came over to us to be prayed for by us, me and my wife. And my wife prophesied over him, saying that God remembers a promise for him through a rainbow. And this man was a businessman, and I really wanted to stop my wife from prophesying like that, because he is a kind of man that will never believe such a thing. But when he heard the prophecy, he was very surprised, and he told us he had just seen a rainbow the day before. And I asked him, where did you see that rainbow? He said that he had seen a rainbow in the park where he and his wife and his family used to go to together. So I encouraged him, you will win the suit, and you will not have to be divorced. A week later, his wife forgave him, and they could be reconciled each other. And this means he won the suit court. And they got together, they were united together, and they once came to our church service together to thank me, Well, since then, they had never shown up. If you are watching this service on the internet, please come back to us. And God, and there is another testimony about rainbow. God told us to move to the middle of Tokyo from Gokubunji City. But what do you think of moving a church to another place where usually where many church members? For them, it would take about 40 or 50 minutes to come to the church to attend the church. You know, moving from Gokubunji to Koenji, that means this. But the Lord told us to move to Koenji, about 40 or 50 minutes away from Gokubunji by train. But as a result, we moved to Koenji. And how we moved, how we decided to move to Koenji was my son John. He was taking entrance exams to enter high school at that time. And he couldn't pass the entrance exam of a high school that was located near Gokubunji. And God opened up for him to enter another high school that was located in the middle of Tokyo. That was a confirmation from God that we should really move to the middle of Tokyo, which is Koenji. And we all prepared and we decided to rent this place. And on the very last Sunday, where we had the last Sunday services in Gokubunji, a double rainbow appeared in the sky. And that was a big double rainbow, and maybe Asahi newspaper they took a picture of this rainbow and published it in the newspaper. I remember. So that was a sign that the Lord would bless us as we were going to move to Koenji. And now we are in Koenji. Somehow, the Lord led me to places with the names that include temple. Ji means temple. You know, I was first. When I first became a Christian, I went to a church in Gotoku, Ji Gotoku Temple. And then I went to a seminary school in Yutoku Temple. And I pioneered a church in Kokubun, Ji Kokubun Temple. And now we are here in Koenji, Koenji Temple. And Pastor Okawa told me that you are the only one who's left in Tokyo. Well, he said that because Pastor Choyongi, who is a pastor of the biggest church in the world, he's a Korean, and he instructed famous five Japanese pastors to go up to Tokyo to start a church. And And but four of them, they retreated from Tokyo. They once went up to Tokyo and they established a church, their churches in Tokyo, but afterward they retreated and they stopped their churches in Tokyo. And having this church in Tokyo has a significant meaning, because God's work in Tokyo is not only for His work in Tokyo. God's hand is wonderful. Let me tell you some more extra things. When we had a holy meeting in Kagoshima Prefecture, in those days, many people criticized our church and slandered us, and I got mad. I was mad, but the Lord told us to give thanks to God for a bad thing. So we would give thanks to God, but the Lord pointed out to me in Kagoshima that I had never danced with joy because of this criticism and slander. So I thought, oh, then I have to dance with joy because of this criticism and the slander. But you know, if I dance in front of people, people would think that I was getting crazy. So I chose to go to a place where nobody was around, and I danced with joy before God. So the Lord told me to leap for joy and dance. So I did. And when I finished dancing, and I look up in the sky, and there, perfect arch rainbow was there in the sky. And I prayed the Lord. I think many of you have seen a rainbow as a sign of blessing from God. You need to pray to God and listen to Him what that rainbow meant for you. And during this outreach in Hawaii, we saw many rainbows. I believe that is confirmation from God about His promises for us for the work in Hawaii. God told us that He would establish a missionary training center in Hawaii, and He would also establish churches in all the islands of Hawaii. And people will be sent to the whole world for His work from Hawaii. And during this outreach, various kinds of people came to attend our meetings. One came from San Francisco. She took a flight for about 4 or 5 hours from San Francisco to Hawaii just to attend this meeting. And another person came to Hawaii from Los Angeles to attend this meeting. And one another person, she also came from Los Angeles. I believe that God is going to do a significant work in Hawaii after this outreach. He will do magnificent work in Hawaii. And we had 4 meetings in Hawaii, and one person who raised a church of about a church of tens of thousands of people. She came and attended all the four meetings. So now I believe that God's promises for us for the, about the work of Hawaii will come to pass. Let us see how and what He is going to do. I also had some answers to prayers. Last week, how many of you had answered prayers? Let's give thanks to God. I think everybody should be given an answer to your prayer from God. Well, if you say that you just pray, the only time you pray to God is before your meal. You say grace, and that's the only prayer. Then you might not have an answered prayer. Well, I made a mistake in the morning services. Some people wanted to share an answered prayer, but I forgot to ask you in the morning services. Who raised up your hand? Joy-chan? One day, trains were delayed, and I was able to get on the bus, but my two other friends, they had to take a taxi. And another Joy. I was on bus to go to a part-time job, and I was posting for a blog on my smartphone, so I passed my destination. I passed three stations from my destination, and I prayed that I had to return, and I prayed that I would never be late for work, and God made it. I arrived at my office 1 minute before the starting time. I also have an answered prayer. That was when I was in charge of a ski camp in Mabashi Church. And I couldn't sleep on the bus at all. And later in the later days, I started to take airplanes, and I couldn't sleep at all on airplanes. But I prayed to God that I'll be able to sleep during the transportation. Now I can sleep. And now I'm able to sleep more, better and better. And at one time I prayed to God that I'll be able to go to sleep just from the instant when the airplane took off, and to the time when the airplane landed, and the Lord answered my prayer, and I actually slept during the flight from the taking off to the landing, and one of the CAs was surprised to see me sleeping so well for that long time. But I gave up sleeping so much on the flight because that would cause me an economy symptom. Of course, the Lord would have helped me, but economy symptom was not very good for my feet. And I also had a job, a work to write articles for a monthly newsletter during the flight. So now I don't sleep so long. But I have a weakness that when I am put in a certain situation mentally, I can't sleep. Pastor Nagato, I went to Tibet with him, and he used to tell me that he had difficulty sleeping. But as I was shared a room with him, he went into sleep 1 minute after he went to bed. Well, there is situation in my mental situation, and when I am in that situation, I cannot sleep. I know that I cannot go to sleep, but this time from Narita to Honolulu, I prayed to God. God, please, you know me. And now I am in a situation that I cannot sleep. But please let me sleep. Because I believed that if it was His will, I'd be able to sleep. So I prayed to God, Lord, if it is Your will for me to sleep, please let me sleep. As soon as I said that in prayer, I went into a deep sleep, and I slept sound. Prayer is a lot of grace. You might have various difficulties and problems. Why don't you use prayer? Why don't you pray? Well, I had four meetings in Hawaii, and you know, in each meeting I gave a seminar, and I also gave a message. All these four meetings were held in the same venue, and that was hard for me because if I hold a holy meeting in the same venue, I know that I cannot give the same message. You might think that I have many testimonies and I don't have difficulty giving different messages, but I do have a lot of testimony, but still it's difficult for me to give a message, give different messages. And in the last holy meeting, I was very tired, and I find myself being unable to speak anything, but I prayed to God. I could pray. I said in prayer, God, you sent me, so you should let me do the work.
Yeah.
Well, so it's not that I tried to do a hard job for God, but because it is God that sent me, God should work through me. Well, at that time, I was driven into a corner because I was very tired. But I prayed these prayers. Then I felt that the Lord really worked in my message more than I expected. Whenever we see works of God, you know, we can be helped by Him through prayers. So prayer, we are able to pray for various things. Prayer is a lot of help. Let's watch a 1 minute video.
みなさんこんにちは。今日のテーマは聖霊のバプテスマについてです。御霊の賜物は9つあり、その働きは教会に与えられています。そして教会の各機関であるお一人お一人を通して表されます。では具体的にどのように表されるのでしょうか。それは聖霊のバプテスマを受けるということから始まります。聖霊のバプテスマとはクリスチャンが聖霊に満たされる最初の現象のことです。それは御霊の賜物の土台です。ですから聖霊のバプテスマの体験がなければ賜物の働きはありません。この聖霊のバプテスマは大きな祝福であり力です。聖書では聖霊のバプテスマを受けた弟子たちを通し印と不思議の技が起こりました。その結果多くの人々が救われ、教会が大きく成長したことが書かれています。神様はこの時代、神様のご計画の成就のためにカリスマの働きを大きく用いられます。その土台である聖霊のバプテスマは全てのクリスチャンが受けることができます。ではまた。
Thank you。The baptism of the Holy Spirit is a great help for your Christian life. When you believed in the Lord Jesus, you were saved and you were given eternal life. And if I compare a relationship between the Holy Spirit and us, for example, it's like water in the glass, like this. But, and the quantity of water is this, but the Lord says we should be filled with the Holy Spirit. So if I give you an example, our condition should be like this glass overflowing with water.Anybody can receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Some people sometimes come to us and they say they can't receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. But it's not right. It is His will, God's will for us to be baptized in the Holy Spirit. So,God will baptize us with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of the Holy Spirit, we will be able to receive more help from God about our Christian life. After I was baptized in the Holy Spirit, I could know God better. I could knowThe guidance of God better, and I could start using the spiritual gifts. And when we do services for God, Whether you have been baptized in the Holy Spirit or you haven't, is a big issue. When I was evangelical, well, and I heard that some people of another religion, the cult, Unification Church, they said, I like it for the shortest story, the Bible story that I spread through in a website. Well, by the way, a long time ago when I was an evangelical, I used to do evangelism near a station, and one day I talked to two strangers to share the gospel, and by the way, a group of Unification Church also, they did street evangelism in front of a station. And on that day, I persuaded these two strangers to accept Jesus, and I explained to them about Jesus, I kind of forced them to accept Jesus, and they prayed together with me, but in my heart I knew that they really didn't accept Jesus. They just prayed together with me because I forced them. And after that, I felt very empty in my heart and went back home. And I read a book of Hudson Taylor, and in reading the book, I realized one thing I could understand, a certain thing through the book. And then I got filled with much joy, and it was so great. I was overflowing with joy. So I thought, maybe in this situation I would be able to speak in tongues, even though I really didn't know what tongues really meant. But I started to move my mouth and lip them, and tongues came to my mouth, and I find myself speaking in tongues a lot. And I got afraid, and I went out of the room, and I stopped. But that was the time when I was baptized in the Holy Spirit. And for the next 2 months, when I shared the gospel with others, I really felt the power of the Holy Spirit working through me, and my words went into deep into the hearts of them that I was talking to, and many people got saved for those 2 months. And so this is one of the works of the Holy Spirit, and we also are able to use the spiritual gifts where we are baptized in the Holy Spirit. And when we are baptized in the Holy Spirit, we are able to have a conviction in the Lord. And we are able to share the gospel with others with conviction. And through that conviction, God works. And some people, they say that even if they don't have manifestation of speaking in tongues, they are baptized. They have been baptized in the Holy Spirit. That's true. For example, holiness. They say that they have experience of being made holy, and they don't operate. They don't use spiritual gifts. They don't speak in tongues, but I think they've been baptized in the Holy Spirit. If you haven't been baptized in the Holy Spirit, seek God. Well, today I cannot pray for you for the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And my wife is not here because she's got cold. I'm sorry, I will have to go home immediately after this meeting. I will have to have curried rice at home for dinner. And then let's look at Psalm 103, verse 10 and 11. He does not treat us as our sins deserve, or repay us according to our iniquities. For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for those who fear him. When you want to do services for God, if you don't have a real understanding about this scripture, you can't stand up in faith firmly. We are sinners. When I had a children's service with children in Mabashi Church, I asked the children, how many of you, who is the one who have never sinned? One child raised up his hand, that's me. Then the other children immediately pointed at him saying, you did this wrong, you did that wrong. We are all sinners, and each of our sins should be judged, and we are condemned to eternal death. But God poured out his love for us, and he forgave our sins. And how forgiveness came to us is through the cross of Jesus. Jesus died on the cross for our behalf. So when we believe in the cross of Jesus and repented of our sins, God will forgive us all our sins. Here, verse 10 says, he does not treat us as our sins deserve. We are sinners, but he treats us as if we have never sinned because we believe in the cross of Jesus and repent of our sins and confess our sins. But here comes some misunderstanding. You know, even after we believe on the cross of Jesus and confess our sins, we again commit a sin. How many of you have never sinned after you believed in the cross of Jesus and confessed your sins? Nobody. We confessed our sins and we are forgiven, but we still commit a sin. You know, the Lord forgives us when we repeatedly commit a sin. You know, everybody commits a sin repeatedly. If there is somebody who has never sinned in this room, maybe that's an ant. Ants, they might bring our sugar to their place, but they don't think that's a sin. When we believe in the cross of Jesus and confess our sins, God will forgive us our sins. It's not that God will forgive us our sins when we stop committing sins. So please make this clear to you. Some of you might have stumbled at this, like you don't feel forgiven even though you believe in the cross of Jesus and confess your sins, because you know that you repeatedly commit a sin. But you are okay. If you share that with somebody else, that person will also be helped. In the beginning of Showa era, many authors, Japanese authors of Japanese literature, they stumbled at Christianity. For example, Osamu Dazai, he tried to be a Christian, but he found himself unable to observe the law, and at the end he committed suicide. We do repeat committing sin, even though we do not do that on purpose. So we are sinners, but God treat us as if we are sinless. This is a basic. And verse 11 says, "For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for those who fear him." This means fearing God, God's grace is big on those who fear him. You know, those who are forgiven their sins, if they fear God, if they put God first, that means if they listen to God's voice and obey it, they will be able to receive grace of God, which is higher than, much higher than the earth. So listen to God's voice and obeying it is very important. Last week I told you, well, last year I traveled first class 19 times. No one of you is not surprised. But this is an amazing thing. Well, I have already been criticized by other churches, but I'm saying this so they think I'm crazy. But interesting thing happened. Whenever I tried to enter the first class section, CAs, they tried to stop me and they asked me, please show me your boarding pass. But in their voices, I felt that they didn't believe that I was a first class passenger. But when I showed my first class boarding pass, they humbled themselves and accepted me into the first class section. The reason why the CAs, oh, now the gifts are back. Oh, it's good that you didn't run short of gasoline, because when I was on the mountain in the car with Pastor Uchida, we ran out of gasoline and we couldn't move. CAs, they didn't believe that I was a first class passenger, because look at my watch is 100 yen, and my jacket is shabby, and my shirt is dirty, and I often had holes in my socks and holes in my shoes. I have heard that women who work at night, when they meet people, they see their watches to see in what level in society they are. So whenever I saw CA on the airplane, they didn't believe me that I was a first class passenger. But because, well, in Hawaii, they purchased new shoes for me. So now my shoes are shoes for the first class. Well, except the shoes, I don't deserve to be a first class passenger. But I traveled first class 19 times last year. You know, we are not qualified. We don't deserve to receive blessings of God. This is right. But we deserve, because God loves us so much, more than anybody else. God loves us. So even though we don't deserve, we are qualified to receive God's blessings. If we put God first and if we listen to God's voice and obey it. In my Christian life, I know that I've been given the best thing from God. Have you eating curry rice that a certain famous female singer cooked for you? I did. I have received many blessings from God because God loves me even though I'm not worthy. Well, these days people ask me to pray for their pets, a dog or a cat. And the other day I was asked to pray for the dog. This dog suffered from cataract, and they told us that they would pay 400,000 yen for the operation for the dog's cataract. But I prayed for that dog, and the dog was healed. Well, God, you know, this person loved his dog so much that he was willing to cost 400,000 yen for the operation. The one issue is whether you seriously seek the best from God. How many of you really seek the best from God? You know, our parent is God. Suppose your father is Bill Gates, Mr. Bill Gates. If suppose you are the only son or the only daughter of Mr. Bill Gates, he will give you the best. You know, we are qualified to receive the best from God when we seek, when we ask Him. Who can receive the best from God? Sinners. You know, we are sinners who commit sins repeatedly. Of course, we have to repent of them. Even when you commit a sin after you repented, then you just need to repent once again. Then God will not only forgive you but also give you the best. So make you need to make this clear that God will give you the best. And sanctification, about the matter of sanctification. Sanctification is becoming like Jesus. In the case of Dazai Osamu, he believed in Jesus, but he thought that he couldn't achieve, and so he stopped being a Christian. But you know, when you believe in Jesus and you have a new life, and you try to be like Jesus, how many of you were successful? Nobody. Well, if some of you had raised up your hand, I would. Yes, but you know, when we try to observe the law, we find out that we can never do that. When we try to do on my own strength, we will fail And we again we recognize or realize that we are still sinners. The law is of the Old Testament times. Faith is of the New Testament times. The way of sanctification is different. Now, sanctification comes through faith. Now, the time is short, so I'm now closing. Remember one basic thing. When you die, we will die. Sooner or later, we will be raptured or die. God told me that I will die, not be raptured. You know, when we go to heaven, or when we die, we will go to heaven. Pastor Rai and Pastor Maureen Carruthers will be there waiting for us. In heaven, we'll be glorified. This means being glorified means becoming like Jesus. You and I will be glorified, will be changed. So our final goal is determined already. We'll be changed and we'll be sinless and we'll be filled with love and filled with joy and peace and righteousness. We'll be like that. We'll be like that. The Bible said that. Let's give thanks to God for that. This is what God will do for us. I'm now recommending to you that you receive and accept this. The Bible says that whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you receive it and it will be yours. So let us receive that it is done. Let's give thanks in faith. Saying, now I'm like Jesus. You know, so let's rejoice over that. What it's important for us to receive what God has done for us. And also the Bible says that we should walk by the Spirit. This means not by our own strength, but by God's power. You know, I had difficulty in sleeping. I tried to sleep, but I couldn't. I asked God to let me sleep, but I couldn't sleep. So I ask God more in prayer. I ask God help me sleep. Once CL was surprised to see me sleep for about 12 hours or 13 hours. Just from the taking off to the landing. But I was sleeping, so that long flight looked just an instant for me. That was done by God's power. The book of Galatians said that we should be led by the Holy Spirit. Then if we are led by the Holy Spirit, we will not have to satisfy our fleshly desires. Because God loves me, God will treat us as if we have we have never sinned before. And blessing, a kind of blessing that the Lord will give to those who have never sinned before are ours. Our forgiveness of sins and sanctification. You need to grasp those things in the right way. Some Christians, they have misunderstanding and they stumble. Even though we are sinners, if we believe in the cross of Jesus and if we confess our sins, we are forgiven and we are made righteous. And God will consider us as ones who have never sinned before. If you stumble, repent immediately. Why? God loves us. God loves us. You know, some people, you might want to slap their face as soon as you see them, but they're still loved by God. And sanctification, and God will prepare sanctification for us. God, please manifest your blessing. You've been thinking a lot in your mind, and that's your thoughts, and your thoughts are different from God's. You need to change your thoughts into the thoughts of God. Please manifest your work. You are tired because you've been doing things on your own strength and you are tired. Go to God and give thanks and seek and repent and ask God. Then you will receive God's solution and guidance. You are disappointed at yourself when you think of a certain thing that happened to in your past, but but being disappointed at yourself is a sin. Repent and give thanks and trusting God. Now let's pray for healing. Dear Heavenly Father, I pray that you will heal us. In the name of Jesus, I command sicknesses to leave us. Be healed. In the name of Jesus, I declare healing. Your gum is swollen, but you are healed. You have difficulty in hearing in your left ear, and you are healed. Your heart is beating, but you are healed. In the name of Jesus, I declare God's healing for each one of us. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.